Hello everyone, this is Kiran Thakur from our YouTube channel Excellence Health Physics. As you know out there, this channel is based upon some basic science questions that we come across in our day-to-day life. So we have got a question that to describe. It is a very most common question that we come across, and let's see what the question is.
One question that we come across in our childhood memory is that why is the sky blue? Despite all the answers provided to us are likely to be partially correct, but not totally. So there are many incorrect answers have been given to us. For example, the sky is blue because it reflects the oceans, or because oxygen is a blue colored gas. So these type of answers are totally incorrect. And in order to understand the answer about these questions, we need to focus on three factors. So let's see what are those three factors are. Three simple factors. The first one is the sunlight, that is made out of light of many different wavelengths. Then the second one is the earth atmosphere, that is made up of molecules that scatter different wavelengths of light by different amounts. So now the second or the last one is that the sensitivity of our eyes. So these three factors will going to make a big impact to understand this answer. So let's see one by one. First factor is that the sunlight. As we know about that, it is made up of all the different colors of light, and the photosphere of the sun is so hot that it emits a wide spectrum of light. As we all know about that, the highest energy light is also the shortest wavelength, having a high frequency, while the lower energy light has a longer wavelength, having low frequency. So when we see a prism, that is split up the light, or maybe the sunlight, into its individual components, the results of the light split up at all because that the fact is redder light has a longer wavelength than the bluer light. So the second factor is very much important to understand, that the atmosphere. As we know that the invisible particles that make up our atmosphere, and what are those particles? Like molecular gases like nitrogen, oxygen, water, carbon dioxide, as well as argon atoms. So all these scatter light of all different of wavelength, but scatter the shorter wavelength light much more efficiently. Because these molecules are all much smaller than the wavelength of light itself, the shorter the light of wavelength is, the better will scatter. While sunlight falls everywhere on the day side of the earth atmosphere, the redder wavelength of light are only 11% as likely to scatter, and therefore make it to our eyes as the violet light is. When the sun is high in the sky, there is why the entire sky is blue. It appears a brighter blue the farther away from the sun you look. Okay, so because there are more atmosphere to see in those directions. In any direction you look, you can see the scattered light coming from the sunlight striking at the entirely the atmosphere, because between your eyes and where outer space begins. This has a very interesting consequences for the colors of the sky, depending on where the sun is and where you are looking. We may have one question that should be asked here. The question is, if the shorter wavelength light is scattered more efficiently, why does not the sky appear violet? The answer is, there actually is a greater amount of violet light coming from the atmosphere than the blue light, but there are also a mix of other colors as well. Because your eyes have three types of cones for detecting the colors in them, so along with the monochromatic light rods, it's the signal from all four that need to be get interpreted by our brains, and it comes to assigning color. It's that combination of three things that we have put together. The first one is that the fact that sunlight is made up of light of many different wavelengths. Then the secondly, the atmospheric particles are very much small and scatter the shorter wavelength, that is much more efficiently than the longer wavelength. Then the thirdly, we have seen that our eyes have the response to various colors, so that makes the sky appears blue into human eyes. So if we could see into the ultraviolet very efficiently, the sky would likely to appear more violet than and also the ultraviolet. If we only had two types of cones like the dog have, so we could see the blue sky during the day.
Thank you so much for watching these videos. We hope you guys learned something from it, and we will come back with another video that is going to be very much interesting. So I hope you guys like this video. So thank you so much again. Have a nice day. Bye bye.